Hey guys, it's Shonda Hunt here with another episode of my Nuke Post series. In today's episode, we will take a look at more of the viewer tools. First, we'll take a look at the input buffers. These three boxes here are known as the input buffers. We have A and we have B, which is currently grayed out, and then we have a drop down here. A will display whatever we have connected to our viewer node. We can also toggle choosing this dropdown. So as many things as we have connected to the viewer node will appear here in this dropdown, and we can switch between them simply using this option. Right now, the B input is not activated, and that's because we haven't chosen anything from this dropdown. This controls the wipe. The wipe option lets you view one image on top of the other, calling whatever you have selected in these drop-down boxes. So right now, I have one input. Since I have two inputs here, I'll just change A to my reformat, B to my crop, and I'll change this to wipe, and then I'll change it to under. A tool pops up here that you can use to wipe between one image and the other. There's also a dot here that allows you to control the mix value. So it goes from 0 to 100. There are other options, over, minus, an onion scan. So these are the input buffers. Usually you'll use the input buffers to simply wipe between your original footage and your adjusted footage. And that's a good way to compare what you've done to the original plate. Next, we have the safe zone, which will give you options to display guidelines on top of your image that will show you the things that will not appear in the final image. These are controlled by the viewer settings. So if we hover in the viewer with our mouse and hit S, which is the keyboard shortcut to bring up the viewer settings, we will see here we have the safe zone options, which are the same options that appear here. You can adjust the settings for each of these here in the viewer settings. So if we want to turn on the title safe, which we have turned on here, and we select one of these options from the mask and region outside ratio, now we will see an overlay over our image. This is usually used in advertising when you're inputting text or some sort of animation that has to be within a certain masked area so that you don't do any sort of animation or add text outside of the masked area, and that will not show up in your final render. So you can adjust all of these options using these options from the viewer settings. So we'll turn that off. And now we'll go over to the masking ratio. And if we click this, this will also give us a drop down of some options to display a mask over our image. So right now it's set to none. Let's set it to lines. And then let's choose some options here. So now we have these lines that appear over our image. And again, this is useful when you have to keep your work inside of a certain area. So we'll switch this back to none. And then we'll move on to the clip warning. The clip warning will apply zebra stripes to all the pixels outside of a specific range. By default, this will highlight any pixels that are outside of the range of 0 to 1. In general, when we're compositing, we want to make sure all of our pixels rest inside of the range between 0 and 1. When we are making adjustments to our images, especially using grade nodes and color correct, it's very easy for our pixels to fall outside of this range, so it's a good option to have. We can see our pixel values here, and that will change if we select different pixels. We see those values changing here, and that's giving us the value of each pixel. Next, we have proxy mode. Proxy mode will toggle between the full resolution and the proxy format, which is set in your project settings. So to open our project settings, remember we hold our mouse in the node graph and we hit S. And this will bring up our project settings. And here we have some options to adjust the proxy. We will usually use the proxy mode when our script is going slow. As we are compositing, very often our Nuke scripts will get heavy and we will have to find ways to optimize our scripts and our workflow so that we can continue working at an efficient speed. And tools like the proxy node allow us to free up some processing time. And it's very helpful, especially now that most projects are being done in 4K. So if we toggle the proxy mode on, we will see the resolution and the format changing here in our viewer. And right now we have our proxy scale set to 50%. So while I still have proxy selected, and this is at 50%, if we move this down, we'll see those numbers changing. And this is only changing right now in the viewer for us. And this is again, simply so that the viewer is processing less. Here we have full frame processing, and if you hover over it, it will give you a brief description, and it simply will just process the full frame when rendering in the viewer. We have a recalculate option that will just recalculate all the pixels again in the viewer. Next, we have the region of interest tool. The region of interest tool is very handy in compositing as it allows you to choose a specific region of your composite to update in the viewer. This is a great tool to cut down on processing time when you want to check work that you've done in a specific area of your footage. If we toggle it on, a box will appear, and this will control what gets processed here in the viewer. You can change the size of this box to whichever area and size you need. You can move it around by selecting here in the middle. So only what is inside of this box will be updated and processed in the viewer. So if we click play on our timeline, only these pixels are being updated. Everything else is remaining the same. Let's move on to the pause button. The pause button will simply pause the viewer so that it's not processing anything. If we go ahead and hit the pause button and press play, our footage will not play because we have it paused. Now, let's toggle the pause off. Now, if we click play, our footage is playing. I find this pause option very handy when I'm opening a heavy script and I want the script to open faster, I'll go ahead and press pause as soon as I can while my script is opening, and that'll help everything load in faster because I don't have to wait for the viewer to process anything. It's also handy if you're moving some things around in your Node graph and you don't want the viewer to process anything. We have a drop down here for some zoom options, as well as the keyboard shortcuts for those options. And then we have the downrest drop down, which allows you to adjust the resolution of the footage that is being displayed in the viewer. And as we're changing these, we can see these values changing. All right, guys, that's all we're going to cover in this episode. In our previous episode, we covered these viewer tools. And as you can see, we still have a lot more viewer tools to go over. The viewer has so many tools and options to help us to see our footage better, to see our footage in different ways, to adjust what we're seeing, to control what's being processed. There's so many things to cover simply in the viewer node alone. And this is important because in the viewer pane, this is where we're seeing all of our work. So it's important to be able to use these tools and see everything the way we need to see it and to adjust things as they need to be adjusted so that we're working efficiently and so that we're also making adjustments that are going to integrate very well. I'll see you guys in the next episode.